In industrial processes, there is a requirement for objects or substances to be moved from place to place. In order to do this, industrial processes use devices called prime movers. Prime movers transfer energy into physical movement. Electricity can be used to power prime movers. Think of a motor that could be used for a rotary movement, such as driving a wheel on a track or a pulley system. If linear movements are required using an electric motor, then screw jacks or rack and pinion gearing may be used to convert a rotary movement into a desired linear movement. Electromagnetic forces can be used for prime movers, usually in the form of a solenoid, where electricity is applied to an electric magnet that moves a shaft a small distance against a spring. However, there are alternatives to electricity when it comes to prime movers. Pressurized fluid and gas systems can be used to move energy from location to location, and also act in linear or rotary fashion. These systems are called pneumatics for gas-filled systems and hydraulics for liquid-filled systems. In this video series, we are going to explore how these pneumatic and hydraulic systems work, from the fundamental principles that govern the systems, including calculations you might need to understand, to practical explanations of the different parts of these systems, including pressure regulation, hydraulic pumps, air compressors and air treatment, actuators and control valves, as well as the accessories to these systems. We will also look at sequencing applications that can be produced using hydraulics and pneumatics in industry. To finish the series, I'll go through some basic fault finding and maintenance information on the systems. If this is a series you are interested in seeing and learning about, then remember to subscribe and check out the following videos in this playlist.